So we so say this, say I have a major part to play in the scheme of God's grace. Okay, watch. Isaiah chapter 60, verse 1. You know it. Can I go? Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Watch this. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth. And the Bible says, deep darkness the people, but the Lord will arise over you, and his glory will be seen upon you. Here's what I want you to see. The Gentiles shall come to whose light? Right? The Gentiles shall come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your rising. Let's read it again like this. Now watch. When you read the scripture, when you meditate on it, don't say you, say me. Let's read it like that. Arise, shine, for my light has come, and the glory of the Lord has risen upon me. For behold, the darkness shall cover the earth and deep darkness people, but the Lord will arise over me. His glory will be seen upon me. The Gentiles shall come to my light. All right? So now God places his, and he's putting his glory on you and I, turning the light on, meaning it's our time to shine, but he's not doing it just for us. He's doing it that, watch this, that others may be drawn to us, that we might point them to him. Can you see it? All right, can you see it? That's it. He's doing this thing. Now the light is on you now. It's our time to shine. It absolutely is. The word is going to be seen, working, manifesting, showing up in our lives. But it's not just for our life. It's that others will be attracted to us so that we can draw or lead others to him. You see it? All right. Go to. Let's look at what the mandate is. Go to Psalm 82. Let's pick up this cause. Say cause. C-A-U-S-E. Cause. So we can't forget that. It doesn't do any good to come to church, get the word change your life, and you never use it to help change somebody else's life. Say, as I get better, I'm going to help someone else get better. When you get out, you bring somebody else out. He only promotes us to put us in a position to help somebody else. That's why promotion comes. Promotion comes so that you and I will be in a position to help somebody else. That's why he gives some of us the spirit or the gift of entrepreneurship. So we start a business so we can have the ability to employ others. That's why he does it. That's why he does it. Did I tell you the chapter, Psalm 82? Did I tell you the verse? Verse 3, Psalm 82, verse 3. Psalm 82, verse 3. You ready? All right, now watch what it says. Defend the poor and fatherless. This is what you do, justice to the afflicted and needy. You'll see in a second. Deliver the poor and needy. Free them from the hand of the wicked. They do not know, nor do they understand. They walk about in darkness. All, what do? They walk about where? In darkness. And our job is to bring them out of darkness. Darkness is because they don't know, don't understand. Our minds have been enlightened because we have the word of God. So our job is to get them out of darkness over into the light. You see it? All right, look at it one more time. Defend the poor. You see it? And fatherless. Do justice to the afflicted and needy. Deliver the poor and the needy. Free them from the hand of the wicked. They do not know, nor do they understand. They walk about in darkness. All the foundations of the earth, the Bible says, are unstable. Hold on for a second. Stay in Psalm 82. Now, look what he tells you and I. He's saying to you and I. He's saying for you and I to defend, free, deliver the poor. He says that the only reason why they're in this state is, watch this, is because they're in what? Darkness. They don't understand. So what he's saying is, the truth of the matter is, it's a mindset, right? Poor would have to be a mindset. Had not it been not been a mindset, Tyler Perry, we wouldn't know Tyler Perry. He can't come from living out of a car to filming movies in his house unless he had a different mindset. If he would have maintained that mindset, you follow me? The only reason why it is because they what? Don't know. It's not like they, the only thing that's holding back from getting out is they just don't know. Oh, God, Jesus. And it's our job, come on now, to bring them, to share some light on the areas where it's dark. Can you see it? All right, now watch. So now, he says to ask us to do all this, and they must have given him a feeling like, or a sense like, how were they going to do it? The very next verse says, verse 6 says, I said you are gods. Oh, Lord Jesus. Then he goes on. He said, well, maybe that was too strong. He says, well, you are the children of the Most High. Amen. So what he said now, what the same, he said he's literally taking our minds back over to John 17. What he's saying is the same glory that God gave to Jesus is the same glory that he gave to you and I. Jesus said, I gave them your word. They've been sanctified by your word. Your word is true. And he who knows the truth shall make you free. So we got free from the word. You follow the truth of the word that's made us free. So take that same word and set somebody else free. Can you see it? So how am I going to do it? I said you're God's. He's trying to give us a God mindset. Can you picture or imagine God worrying about paying the light bill in heaven? Oh, Lord Jesus. Can you imagine God saying, man, how am I going to, man, they're going to turn my cell phone off? Can you see God saying, oh, my God, Jesus on the main line. But Verizon, No, can you see it? It's just he said having that type of mindset, that type of mentality. I know that God has me. He's got me. Watch this. He's my source. He's not just my source because he's God. He's my source because I'm his child. You see it? Remember what he said before? Don't go there. In Isaiah 55, our thoughts are not his thoughts, our ways are not his ways. But that's just because he didn't say we couldn't have his thoughts. In fact, the Bible says we have the mind of Christ. Look at somebody and say, you look just like God. Did you read it in your Bible? I didn't add that in there, did I? All right, go to Psalm 62. Psalm 62. Let's see what he's talking about. Psalm 62. Psalm, say it again. Say it one more time so you can get a God mindset. Say I operate and function in this earth. Just like God. Because as Jesus is, so am I in this world. If I speak it, it's got to come to pass. All right, let's meet over there in Psalm 62. Psalm 62. Psalm 62. Ooh. Say, I flow in the supernatural. Because my daddy is supernatural. Say, keep watching. I shall rise, shine, be on top soon. Yeah, Psalm 62? Ooh, Jesus. Verse 5. Psalm 62, verse 5. Psalm 62, verse 5. Can I go? Now watch this. He says, my soul waits soundly for God alone, for my expectations from him. He only is my rock and my salvation. He is my defense. I shall not be moved. All right, now let's go to Ecclesiastes chapter 7. Ecclesiastes chapter 7. Thank you. Ecclesiastes chapter 7. When you have it, look at verse 12. We'll pick it up from there. Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 12. Jesus. Woo. He alone is my salvation, right? He is my defense. Watch, it's going to make sense in a second. It's going to make sense in a second. Stay with me. My expectation is from him. Jesus. Psalm 62, you meditate on that. That gives you a God mindset, meaning God mindset means I'm counting on him and him only. I'm looking at him and him only. That's having, when I say have a God mindset, we got job mindset. How much you make? You gonna give me a cost of living? Oh, Lord, tax time. Some people have it, some people not. Job mindset. We're gonna get you off a job mindset. Don't keep your job, but keep you off a job mindset. We'll give you a what? God mindset. He alone is my expectation. Where am I going? Ecclesiastes chapter 7, correct? Ooh, boy, verse 12. You ready? For wisdom is a defense as money is a defense. All right, so he said, do what? Defend the who? So he was saying, what do the poor need? And word. Remember, money and, come on, word. Poor is an insufficiency in any area. You can have poor health, right? Poor isn't just financially. You can have poor health. You follow me? So they yes, It requires financial, but they need to work. Remember he said to the poor, the gospel is preached. So if they need something, I have to watch this. God's telling you and I to meet their physical as well as spiritual needs. You see? Well, he said, well, how am I going to do all that, Lord? What all I got to do? He says, money is the defense. That's what I'm saying, Lord. Then he said, God is the defense. So God is my defense. So whatever I need, God is. Can you see it? So God's not, watch this. Watch this. Oh, Lord Jesus. Watch this. God's not asking, Okay, watch. The Bible says, he who gives to the poor lends to God. And whatever you give, the Bible says, he will repay. You follow me? He who gives to the poor, the Bible says, lends to God. And whoever gives, watch this, God will, repay. Oh, Lord Jesus. See, watch this. Job mindset or provision-minded people think like this. They think that they're scared that they're going to run out. They're the ones who say, you know, if I had it, See, because you provision mindset, you're thinking, you know, I would, but when I get it, when my taxes come in. I'm gonna help you. Amen. Come on, amen. See, we watch this. You know, when you come to God, you start coming to church, and get you like to Christ, you start coming to get in the Word. Your heart changes. You start having compassion on people. That's why the enemy doesn't like that, because now he's like, oh, now they're gonna help somebody else. Oh man, I couldn't stop them. Now they're going, oh my gosh. So then he just wreaks havoc in your life. Just try to turn your life upside down so that you won't, because now your heart is changing. You start thinking about people like you never thought of. Like, you start being concerned. You start seeing the good in people. Before, you couldn't see nothing but what they were showing. You know, however they was acting, that's how they was, and that's how you carried it. You'd be like, yeah, okay, silly self. You know, now you got compassion. You tell me it's going to be all right. Before, you was talking about it. They're so silly. They keep doing the same dumb stuff again. Now you're like, don't worry about it, baby. Listen, remember how I told you? Now you're all patient. Then after that, you start going in your wallet. Yeah, come on, you know that wouldn't have been you before. You wouldn't have been you. When you first start doing that, after a while, you get to the restaurant, you start thinking about it. If I wouldn't have gave them that, man. But I guess it was the right thing to do. You know. But then you move from that to being like, you know, happy. You be excited. You be like, you know, God, thank you for allowing. So the enemy doesn't want that. He wants to keep us provision minded. Tell yourself, I'll never run out. It's impossible for you to run out. Oh, my God. Okay. Hurry up, Pastor Bill. Okay. You remember the woman with the oil? See, I just got a little jar of oil. He didn't ask her to get more oil. She thought she needed more oil. She was worried about running out. He said, you don't need more oil. You need more containers. God. Don't pull your mind up in a little while. Stretch it. Hey, what's happening? You need to pick up the young people. You need to pick up the young people. She's way down. now she up here. Now she thinks she's grown. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if she got a job and bills. That might qualify her as grown. She grown? Mama says she grown. Well, that's true. Think. Y'all do know they're not really grown until they're about 30. Yeah. They're not. They're really not. So you can't be yelling, you 24. You think of you at 24. Even if you had your own spot, you still thought you were, if I rule the world. You know, you was crazy. You know, you was out there. You thought you could King Kong. You know. When life hits you, you got to phone home. And so she was thinking provision minded. Look at the language. What do you tell me what you have in the house? All I have is a little cruise of oil. See, thinking she's gonna run out. He tell your son, go get some pots, as many pots as he can find. She probably thinking, what am I going to do with pots? What, he can't see? I got a little cruise of oil, man. This ain't even going to fill up one pot. The story, you know how the story went. She never ran out. So when you get God-minded, you don't think I'm going to run out. Tell yourself, I'm not going to run out. You got more money than month. Jesus. I'm going to help you. By the time we get to this, you're going to be charged up. You're going to be like, yeah. You run out if you think you're going to run out, because you hold on to what you got to release. All right, hold the money in your hand, squeeze it. Do all you want to do is jump up and down and throw it on the ground, move on around it. When you pick it up, it's still going to be the same. You got to do something with it. I'm going to show you. Woo! Woo! See, oh, Jesus. I remember I used to think people was running game. And from time to time, I still think, you know. Like, you know, the new one now, they come to you. I don't know if it's new because they've been doing it for a minute. You pumping gas, they come to your car. Then they got sophisticated. Now they got keys in their hand. My car right over there. You see, I be in Maryland. They say, I just need to get to Virginia. Can't give me a couple. Now, a couple dollars can't get you to Virginia. Gas, $4.15 a gallon. That off the break tell me you don't have a car. Or if you got one, you don't put gas in it. Because a couple of dollars at $4.15 a gallon and you in Waldorf ain't going to get you to Virginia. Yeah, you're going to crank it up. By the time you get up the street, it's the little engine light going to cut on. Yeah. Here's what I'm saying. If God leads you to give to people, give. Amen. That's because that was my mentality, you know. Oh yeah, right. Okay. But now I listen to God. God say, give it, give it. Because he who gives to those who have lack, lend to God. And he who lends to God, God will. See, it's a cycle or flow that makes sure that I never run out. Watch this. Where did I leave you? Ecclesiastes? Okay, can I go? Can I leave? Okay, come on. You ready? You want some more? Can I go? Ah! I'm excited. I'm sorry. I'll be lunching. Deuteronomy chapter 8. Come on. I'm rushing you. That's terrible. This is good stuff right here. You're so much further than you give yourself credit for. So the enemy just got you in this mindset, you know, that no, you're light years ahead of where you thought you were. You got too much word to be the same. You're not the same you. You just gotta walk into that newness. Step over in the light, stand in the light, and walk in this glory. You follow me? You're not where you were. And you're further than you think you are. I got so much further to go on God. No, not really. What God is saying, I'm going to take you so much further in me. Because of where you already are. Jesus Christ. Just trust me. Hang in there with me. I'm going to take you to places you never thought you would ever even. Oh, my Jesus. And along the way, every place that the sole of your foot treads, I've already given it to you. You listen, he said, listen, there's a source of, y'all pulling on me, there's a source of a flow that's going to rush out of you, that's going to startle yourself. Boy, we had a healing service in the middle of service in Waldorf. Okay, I'll say it again. We had a healing service in the middle of service in Waldorf. The lady was on the cane. She's got discoloration. She has bone cancer. She has discoloration in her. She received the healing, stood up on her own. Hands stretched to God, tears streaming down her face, stood up on her own. Woo! God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? God ain't got time for you to be provision-minded. He got miracles that got to come out of you. Lord Jesus said, I want to pray healing. I want to pray. She believed God for giving healing. All the praise. So she said, I want to heal her today. I was like, okay. The presence was high. I didn't know what to do. So I waited on God. I said, and she went, prayed. Woman stood up on her own. Crying. Now watch. The glory hit her and her sister joined the church. God ain't got time for you and I to be provision minded. He said, I got that. Heal the sick. Okay. Can I go? Where did I go? Verse 18. Ooh, Jesus. Good God Almighty. I love God. You love him? And you should, did I say the verse? And you should remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you the power to do what? Get wealth. Why? That he may establish his covenant as he swore to his fathers as it is this day. In other words, remember, in you and I, all families of the earth are supposed to be blessed. So we've been hearing this saying for some time now, we're blessed to be a blessing. Well, now it's time to be a blessing to people spiritually, physically, and financially. Make them what? Whole. Here we restore families. We make you whole. See, he said, well, how you restore a family? One member at a time. One family member at a time. How you restore families? One family member at a time. Oh, my God. Let me say it again. How you restore families? One family member at a time. You start sharing the love of God with one family member. That family member gets whole. That family member starts sharing the love of God with another family. Before you know it, the whole family whole. That's how we restore families. One family member at a time. How we do it? Just sharing the love of God. How you do that? Sharing the word of God. How you do that? Following the Holy Spirit. How I do that? Give experiences. Tell people the experience that how God has come through for you. Share those experiences. Take them step by step, line upon line, precept upon precept. How I do that? Maintain a life of prayer. Pray for them. Don't just pat them on the back. It's going to be all right. Say, you know what? No, what? You know what? You know what? You know what, auntie? Listen. You know what, uncle? Listen. And you get to praying. The glory of God will show up. Something will rise up in them. Uncle have a boldness that he never had before. Come back and tell you know, I got that job. Boy, when you pray for me, come on, you hear? Thank you. That's the only reason why he gives it to us. He gives us the wealth so that our mind won't be stuck on provisions, and so we have enough to help somebody else, so that we can do what our heart says, and don't let our head talk our hearts out of doing what God is leading us to do. Okay, can you see it? Jesus. Ooh, Jesus. All right. Let me rush a little bit and just take you two places. All right. Okay, let me show you. Go to Psalm 35. Rushing me, not rushing you. Because I want to show you something. Then I owe you some time from last week, so I'm going to get you out early. Psalm 35, amen. Yeah, you know, I know. I'm going to pay my, you know, I want a man nothing but love, so let me hurry and pay you so that we're straight. I said, y'all see y'all driving to church today. All right. I sure hope Pastor, I hope we don't be along with yours last week. I know my kids. Psalm 35, verse 27. You there? Now watch. Let them shout for joy and what? Be glad. Psalm 35, verse 27. Let them shout for joy and be glad. Who? Who favor my what? Righteous what? Cause. We saw the cause. The cause is in Psalm 82. That's a portion of the cause. He said, who favor my righteous cause, let them say continually, let the Lord be magnified, who has pleasure. What does he say? In the what? Not failure, but the prosperity of his servants. In Lamentations 3, we read it Wednesday night. He said, the prophet Jeremiah said, my soul has moved far from peace. I have forgotten prosperity. It's going to take finances, but it's not just for us. See, when the body of Christ called on that God didn't want us struggling, living paycheck to paycheck, hand to mouth, we lost our mind and forgot to share, forgot what his intention was, what his purpose was. Say, money has a mission. Yeah, money has to be released. Amen. That's right, it has a purpose. Oh, Jesus. Watch this. Watch this. Okay. Okay. All right. Let me take you two places, and then I'm going to get you out early. So go to Psalm 112. I'll take you two places. Psalm 112. Okay. Woo, maybe three. Psalm 112. I got to show you this, and then I'll be done. Start in verse 1. Verse 1. Psalm 112, verse 1. You there? Praise the Lord. Bless, not praise the Lord that you're there. That's what it says. Psalm 112, verse 1. Praise the Lord. Blessed is the man who fears the Lord, who delights greatly in his commandments. His descendants will be mighty on the earth. Now, that descendants means his children. I want you to begin to do this, not just over your children's lives, but over the children at Open Bible, over your little cousins, little nieces, little nephews. You say that my nieces, my nephews, my children's, my child, or my, you're following me, the kids at Open Bible will be mighty in the earth. Begin to declare and decree it. All right, you, because you have a right to it. Okay, well, let me keep going.